trying out a mic'd up push day. So it's pretty busy and it's super loud in here. So hopefully you can actually hear me with the mic and not just the music. Dude, the legs look sick. They look sick. Huh? I feel like I never see you like actually like flex your legs. Like you're said, I feel like I never actually see you like flex your leg. Yeah. They what? Honestly, dude, your legs look like pretty lean.
Yeah, for 50s. I might try and get 110s today. We'll see. Huh?
I'm right there.
Alright. Alright, I see you, I see you. But, yeah, we're gonna see if we can get maybe 105s, 110s today.
I was just home for Christmas,
and the gym had 90s, and then it goes to 120s. So I haven't done anything more than 90 in like 3 weeks. So we're gonna see. Oh, but yeah, I think today, pretty much just gonna kinda like explain
what I do to grow my chest pretty much, because that's definitely my strongest muscle group. So I'll just go through a full day, full push day, and kinda explain everything I do, why I do it. Right now, just warming up, let's grab like pretty lightweight for me, it's 50s right now, and just do like honestly anywhere from like 2 reps to like 8, and kind of just sitting here hanging out, stretching, feeling out the movement. And like already I didn't film it, but I already warmed up my shoulders and my rotator cuffs, hence why I'm like already sweaty. But yeah, now we're gonna jump like probably like 80s. Do a couple reps, see how they feel.
D press.
Had a bunch of people ask me lately why I write in the notebook instead of just doing it on my phone. And I used to do it on my phone for like years, and then it just got to the point where I feel like I'm on my phone so much already that it just feels like better to write it down. But also too, like when I was using my phone, I would put down like the chest day, and then the next time I went in, I would just like override last week's workout and put in the new weights and new reps. So I'd never actually like save it. And so by doing it this way, I now just every time have a new page. And so like for instance, I just went home for Christmas, was able to go to my old gym and go back to the dates that I was home and see the exact weights that I was using on the exact machines while I was home. So now I know exactly like how much I can do or if I've been stronger, obviously since last being home. Like I went home and it was like cool to see like, oh, I know that on this exact machine, I used to only do like whatever, 210 for 8, and now I'm doing like 250 for 10 or something like that. So it is just kind of nice to write it down. But anyways, second warm-up set. Oh. Just gonna do 80s for like maybe 4, see how it feels.
All right, that feels pretty good.
Shoulder feels good too. So, let's see. Last time we were here, we got 110s for 5, and then 100s for 7. Whoa, wait, what? That can't be right. I don't remember hitting 110s. Hold on. 110 for 5? I do not remember. Dude, apparently I've already done 110s. I didn't think I could do 110s, but...
How many reps did you get?
5, according... But I didn't think I'd done 110s yet. Huh? I know. Like, I was just saying, like, I don't think I've ever tried 110s, so I guess now I have to. I'm gonna go for 110s because I haven't, huh? I haven't. I don't even know if I can do them. Like, since when I went home, the home gym that I go to has like 90s and then 120s. So I couldn't do an in between. So I've only touched 90s the last like 3 weeks. So I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna try it right now. All right, we're going right into it. 110s. Apparently I already got them like a few weeks ago for 5. So I'm gonna try and get 5. But I gotta go headphones on for this one. Fuck me, that is heavy.
You got breathe. Breathe. Up. Come on. You got reps. Quest. Go. Lock it up. Come on. You got at least two. Go. Lock it. I'm not helping. Come on, lock it out. Money, I'll help you here. Come on, lock it out.
Dude, I like.
I'm straining right here.
Bro, I like honestly think I like wrote something wrong. Like, I'm gonna have to go back and look. Cause that felt so heavy. Like, I don't think I've done one.
The first like 3 looked really good. Fourth one looked good too at the spot. The last one was a fucking.
Yeah, the last one I felt like I wasn't doing shit.
No, I was here fucking.
Holy. Alright, man. What class? Oh, no way. Nice. Oh, yeah, because now you're done with, like, finals and everything. Or midterm. Yeah. All right, see you, man. Thank you for the spot. Holy shikaka. All right. That was a perfect example of a terrible set. Kind of, like... Like, I'm writing that down as 110 for 3 plus 2 assisted reps. Because that was like, I don't know. I think that's a good example of like, for me, I don't care about the weight. Like, obviously I want to lift as much as I can. But that was just sloppy. Like, I feel like I was so focused on how heavy it was that I wasn't even focused on the actual reps or the form. Or like stretching my chest, contracting my chest. It's like that's one of those sets that I don't know. I think sometimes you need to just like take your medicine, drop the weight, and focus on like 6 reps of like perfect form, perfect control, perfect tempo, contraction, activation, everything like that. Because I think that's where you're gonna grow is when you have reps like that. But each week to week, getting stronger. So, honestly, I think I'll probably drop to hundreds and try and get like 8 reps. Because according to my notebook, on the 18th of December, I did like 110s for 5 and then 100s for 7. So the way I look at it is if I can try and get hundreds for 8, but like really, really good form, perfect form, then that's what matters to me. You know, that's a successful lift, essentially. Because that was too heavy. Like I said, last time we tried them, I got them for 7, I believe. So, if I can get 8 really good reps, I'll be happy. Thank you. bitch.
Wow.
That's not good. That's like, that's frustrating. That was only 5. And that felt so heavy. But that's like perfect example of how, like, just traveling, not eating right for even a couple weeks can definitely like hinder your progress in the gym. Like, that's why it is one of those things where it's like, that's why I weigh out every meal every single day. That's why I always get 8 to 9 hours of sleep. Like, I don't like that feeling that I just had. And so, like, being disciplined doesn't even feel like being disciplined. It just feels like, I don't know, it doesn't feel hard. It doesn't feel hard to weigh out your food and do all those daily habits when you go to the gym and you see how much it transfers into your workouts. Then it just makes it all worth it. And then the other end of the spectrum is when you don't do those things, those daily habits, or eat correctly, and then you see the negative effects in the gym, it just makes you even more so want to dial it back in. So I'm gonna drop the weight again, try and do like 90s, I guess, for maybe 8 or so. And yeah, I mean, I think this right now is like eye-opening that I gotta lock the fuck back in. No traveling for like the next 6 months at least, and I don't know, get back into a good zone. Again though, one good thing that to kind of think about from this is not every single lift is gonna be like a 10 out of 10 lift. Not every single workout you're gonna be stronger. And that's where sometimes you just need to like accept the fact that today is not gonna be your strongest day and just try to find some other way to make it a good workout. So like for me, maybe that means an extra set. Maybe it means putting more of an emphasis on triceps today, or more of an emphasis on shoulders, or trying is like getting stronger in one movement. You know, if we're not stronger on incline dumbbell press, maybe we can be stronger on like an incline hammer strength press, you know? Not every single day. You're not just gonna be stronger on every single exercise. So sometimes you just kind of accept that, take the hit, and find another way to make it a good workout. But again, any workout's a good workout at the end of the day. Drop to 85s. I honestly haven't done a working set with 85s probably since I like started the bulk kind of. So it's like a little frustrating, but you know, sometimes the weights just fucking feel heavier, man. That's the way it goes. Wow, we're a little weakling. I don't even know how many that was, like maybe 6 or 7. We'll say 7. That way next lift, it kind of makes me push. Sometimes if I forget how many reps I did, I'll overestimate. That way next workout, instead of being like, oh, I only have to get 6, be like, oh shit, like last lift I set the standard, I have to get 10, you know? Not quite that exaggerated, but even if it's just 1 or 2 reps more than you actually did. All right, moving on to plate loaded. Machine press incline again. Normally, so like in the past, I think one of the best ways that I grew my chest, and one of the things that helped me the most, was I'd always pre-exhaust. And I know that that's not necessarily the most optimal thing, but if you struggle to feel your chest, especially on big movements like an incline barbell press, incline dumbbell press, doing some sort of isolation movement like a pec deck fly or cable flies, anything like that, and just doing like two sets to failure and then going into your heavy lifts, yes, you're going to be weaker than you normally would be if you started with it, but the activation that I would get from that and the mind-to-muscle connection, I did that for years, pretty much probably for the first 8 years that I went to the gym. I would do that with most muscle groups. I'd pre-exhaust my lats, my chest, and I feel like that helped me so much with growing those muscle groups because I had that mind-muscle connection. And now I don't necessarily need to do it. But if I feel like mixing it up or if I feel like I'm not getting the activation that I want, I can throw that in. But yeah, we're gonna, that's definitely not set up correctly. See how this feels. But yeah, this year, or this bulk, yeah, I guess this past year, I've gotten more in the habit of, instead of doing that pre-exhaust movement, just doing two incline movements, heavy, like two main incline compound movements. Pretty much no flat movements, except for like pec deck. I don't do really any flat pressing. It's all incline and then accessory work. So we're gonna see how this feels. Hopefully this is just set up right on the bench. No, it is not. Definitely not. Over there. Maybe there. Oh. I don't know why this feels as weird as it does right now. There we go. God damn, man. So weak. So again, dropping the weight because we kind of have to. Two plates 25. I'm gonna toss the headphones on. I do definitely think I'm realizing that I've become so dependent on SoundCloud that I'm definitely not used to working out without music. I mean, I honestly don't think I've lifted without music, I don't know, 60, like, no, probably even more, like 8 years since I probably first started. And then especially SoundCloud, like, as cringe as some people may think it is, listening to like Tom Platz, David Goggins and those things while you work out truly does improve your workouts. So we're gonna have to apparently kind of taper off and get used to lifting without it. But for now, I'm gonna use it. Not a good feeling having that weight coming back down. Like, oh, thought I had it, but it was still a good set, still achieved failure. Just gotta do what you can, make the most of it. Like I said, you're not always gonna be your strongest, but you can't really control that, but you can control your effort how much you put into it. Because at the end of the day, like, I don't know, what's the point of even coming to the gym if you're not going to put everything you have into every single set, every single rep, every single exercise? You might as well just go home, you know? Who gives a shit if you're not as strong as you were a week ago? You can still work harder than you did a week ago. You know, it's not all about the weight. Yeah, I was about to say, I can probably just...
I'll figure out what you're into.
But I say, it might as well leave that there for you.
I'm also like, I just started a cycle at like 225 right now.
You what?
I just started a cycle at 225 right now. So again, when I say like different games.
So like, what's your... You said your stage weight is like 205, right?
205.8 with my pro card weight.
When you got your pro card?
I was 2.5 pounds lighter than when I got competed through beforehand.
And so what's your weight limit or your weight cap?
So as a pro now, I get an extra 10 pounds from what the amateur division will be. They did some better weight cap this year for men's physique.
Your men's physique?
I'm small men's physique.
You're 205. That's insane.
That's a small men's. I was the second smallest guy in my class.
Damn.
The only guy that was smaller than me was the guy that probably should have been.
Do you want to compete in Classic eventually or no? Like, do you feel like you are better mentally?
Probably.
Huh?
Probably early 30s.
Yeah.
Because I want to progress. My whole thing is, like I just told you, feel up and feel down.
Yeah.
And I'd rather continue up and outgrow it than to limit myself and not be able to progress.
Yeah.
So, I'm 6 foot. I'm fighting over, under. So,
yeah.
6 foot and 1/8, and then 5'11 and 7/8. But if I height in over 6 foot, my weight cap is 224.
224? Holy shit.
So we're talking...
Like literally another 20 pounds of muscle?
Minimum my weight cap is 217. Which you're talking 12 pounds of tissue and then maybe another 3 or 4 pounds of loss. So maybe like 15 pounds of tissue.
God damn. So what are you trying to step on for this next show? Like, do you have a show already in mind?
No. So I was actually talking to my client about this morning. She was talking about how she set a 6-month timeline for when she wanted to do something. I said, timelines are bullshit. Don't set a timeline. Set a threshold of like accomplishment as the barrier. And then because if you do it in 3 months,
if
you do it in 6 months, if you do it in 9 months, but the number is arbitrary. If you're not doing any work during that time, you're not going to fucking...
Yeah, like who cares how long it takes? It's just a matter of if you get it done.
6 months doing nothing.
Yeah.
And so I told my coach, I will hop on stage when I am within... I'll height it in the off season to figure out my height, you know, make sure. If I'm within realistically 3 pounds of my weight cap, I will do a diet first. Right? So when I look at it and I go, okay, last off season I was 237 in my heaviest.
Mm-hmm.
So this year if I'm like 250, then I'll know I'll be able to get back down to that weight.
Yeah.
If I go to 245, I know I still have 5 or 6 pounds of tissue to grow.
That makes sense.
Because I can gauge my off season progression versus my stage weight and kind of keep like a 30-pound barrier or so.
250 is insane. Is that like kind of like where you're setting your mark, 250 this offseason? That's crazy.
Yeah, man plans to God last, so we'll see.
Yeah.
But I'm 6 foot, so like 250 is different on me than like a 5'5".
Yeah.
Like Chris Bunce is 6'2", and he stays lean in the offseason. He doesn't really grow as much.
Yeah.
He's 265, 270.
That's so crazy.
So like, I'm 6 foot, 2 inches shorter, which means about 15 pounds of tissue I need less than him if I ever wanted to like compete.
At that level.
So I need to be 250 at like 9%, 10% if I was going to be,
Ramon
was 30 pounds over his weight cap at 9 weeks out last year.
Holy.
And he was like 7% body fat.
So he just had to like literally lose muscle.
Yeah.
Oh my God. That's crazy. Like, but like that's the time, like that's the stuff where it's like genuinely funny to me when like if people are like, oh, you're on steroids, it's like, dude, like have you met anyone that's like actually knows how to train, knows how to eat, and knows how to properly take shit? Like I would be
here.
Huh?
I know a guy in here. I won't say names.
Yeah.
I know a guy in here who's late 20s. His cycle, his off-season cycle was heavier than anything I've ever ran.
Was what?
Heavier than anything I've ever touched.
Yeah.
Like the amount of drugs and the volume of drugs that I've ever touched. And you would not think this guy was even taking creatine.
Yeah. All right, so hopefully you guys heard that whole conversation. I will say that was like probably 20, 25 minutes of me talking to him, which like, I'm not gonna lie, I was basically standing there flexing my chest so that I didn't lose my pump, which I did. Kind of feel like I need to like warm up again. But that, like that conversation, hopefully you could hear it, like covered everything of why I'm still natural and why I just have no desire, at least anytime in the near future, to take any sort of PED. And like honestly, we kind of covered the reasons of why I think it's so stupid how many people are like now hopping on God knows what at such a young age. Like I don't know, it's kind of sad to see, and it seems like it's already too far gone to try and change how the industry is, but maybe I can have an effect, you know, to try and convince more people to stay natural and figure out what you can actually achieve naturally if you fucking put in the work for years on end with proper training, proper nutrition, and just sickening consistency. God, I love this machine. So normally I would definitely do like a pec fly in the past, like on a pec deck. But since moving out here to California and going to this gym, this machine is just so fun. So I've just never really used one or had the opportunity to use one. So we're gonna do like 1 to 2 sets here. Again, mostly just focusing on form, good contraction. Also try and just get back into the swing of this lift. All right, this will be the first working set on here. I haven't even taken this t-shirt off because I kind of got my pump and then lost it. So now we got to get it back. Just going to do as many reps as I can. That was like 10, it's around there. Definitely kind of got the pump back. So if you guys have noticed too, I also time out my rest. I like always, it's probably, again, some of the stuff that I do is just OCD. Like it's just like, I don't know, I just like being precise and like knowing the exact times. But for movement like this, that's less of like a big heavy compound, typically I'll rest like about 2 minutes total. Same with arms, about 2 minutes, or like shoulders, things like that. But for any heavy pressing or a pulling, leg movements, typically a minimum 3 to 5 minutes rest. And again, I always time it out. But We'll pop the pump cover off and see if we're looking kind of small, which we are. So we definitely need to get this pump going again.
Why is that lace so far up?
Do a drop set just cuz. Cables are taken that we'd normally do triceps on, so we're gonna just start with shoulders. Honestly, I think the only thing you need is lateral raises and maybe some overhead dumbbell press. And then double the weight and just partials. That is how you fry your shoulders, I'm telling you, man. Doing like a normal set of like, I don't know, anywhere from 6 to 12 reps of like your normal working set weight, and then immediately dropping the weight, grabbing like around double what you just did in weight. Try to just rep out like 15 partials or even more if you can, and just don't stop. Like, don't ever stop and like pause and hang at the bottom. Even if you're barely moving, just try and keep like that tension on your delt. I'm telling you, that I think is what been like the number one thing that has blown up my delts. The delts are honestly pumped right now, just after the one set of that. See how the right side's looking. Honestly, I think the left side looked better. But yeah, that's one set. Really, for like my push days, I only do two sets of that, and then my delts are done. But again, once my left shoulder feels better, I'll probably incorporate overhead dumbbell press again, because I think that's what builds like the huge roundness of your shoulders, especially when you hit like a back double bicep. Second set of this, up the weight just for the partials. Like my normal working set is still 25s, and then I'm gonna go to 45s. And then right into partials. I'm telling you, man, those are absolutely brutal. Like, the delt pump you get from those partials is just insane. It's not bad. Could be better. All right, on to the tricep portion of the push day. This is literally all I do for triceps. This, I'll do this and then one other movement. But normally I would do it on a different cable machine, but they're all taken. Simple as that. So for these, like, pretty much the main thing I'm focused on, so I feel like when most people do like a rope push down, the rope is so short that you get like literally stuck here and you basically just have to internally rotate your shoulders and you can't even get like a full contraction. So normally, like, I would do it on a cable machine, like the pulleys or whatever you want to call it, where there's cables on both sides. That way I can typically hold something to support myself, like just with my left arm. But pretty much I'm just making sure I don't internally rotate, and then I'm just kicking my hand behind my body and just contracting as hard as you can. Keep your elbow pretty much locked on your chest and then try and stretch it out. And then same thing, once you get to the end, you can literally just help yourself get those assisted reps. Let go of it on the way up, control the eccentric, and then if you're not strong enough to get the concentric, again, just help yourself out a little. It's like having a lifting partner. I think I got 8 reps on my own and 2 assisted plus partials at the end. So we're gonna try and match that or beat it with our left. Mm. That is just gnarly. Last set of this, two sets total. Again, you only got two sets, so you gotta make them count.
Oh, this also might be better. Oh.
Oh, man, these are killer, dude. Like, after doing one set, literally one set, on the second set, just contracting at all is like genuinely painful. Like, it hurts. I'll tell you what though, this last like year of actually prioritizing my arms has made such a difference. Like training arms to failure, training arms heavy, like 5 to 10 reps instead of doing like 8 to 12, like not truly to failure. Like, yeah, I used to train hard, but not to the point where I was physically incapable of doing one other rep or doing force reps or rest pause sets or partials. I just got really quiet in here. But the reason I bring that up is because after just like 1 year or so of doing that, like already, like just now the guy I talked to earlier, like already people come up to me and compliment usually my arms now, which to me I thought was like my worst muscle group, and now they're most frequently the things people comment on. Like multiple times now, I'll have someone come up to me on a leg day and just be like, what are you training, arms? Purely because, I don't know, my arms have just grown to the point where even when they're not pumped, they're filled out. I think that's the beauty of like bodybuilding. It's like, it's totally up to you what you prioritize and what you grow, what you want to be your strong points. On to the only other thing I do for triceps. I gotta figure out how much weight I can do. But that is the beauty of having a notebook. It's like kind of just makes it so you don't waste sets, you know? I feel like I used to waste sets trying to figure out how much I could lift or like what would be a good working set weight. Now I don't have to do that. I can just look. So like right now I'm gonna try and get 23 because I know that it was on this machine. I'm gonna try and get 23 for 10, because last time I got 9. But I have been weaker significantly on every movement today, so we're gonna see what we can do.
like actually hurts. Doing partial, or not even partial, force reps like that, and then just sitting at the bottom of the movement where you get that stretch right there is like the most painful thing ever. It's just an insane burn. All right, onto the right arm. Sometimes you only need one set of those. Like, if you train heavy to failure, with proper form, and you rep out like force reps or partials, I'm telling you, man, you need way less volume than you think. Way less volume. That's a perfect example, though, of like, I was weaker on pretty much every single movement today, but this one I was stronger by like, not significant, but enough where it makes a difference, you know? I think that's the things, that's what people are missing, is they think like, oh, it's not that big a deal. You know what I mean? Like, it's just one rep, it's just two reps. But think about those one or two reps more or extra every single lift for years on end. I think that's how you build like a physique naturally that people think is, you know, like, I think that's how you build a physique naturally that people think is enhanced, is you do the little things.
It is. I can't really tell how this looks, but I just found this and there's like no one in here. It's kind of sick with like the all black background. And just biggest in general, like.
I think
I'm starting to realize that the work that I'm putting in, the insane discipline to the point where people think I have an actual problem, an eating disorder, all the sacrifices I'm making over these last few years are truly paying off to the point where I like, that's why I want to be consistent on YouTube. I want to show what it takes to get to where I am. And I know that I have so far to go. And I, like I said, I know I'm not the biggest, the strongest, the leanest, the best genetics, this, that. But if there's this many people talking to me about how I look in a positive way, then I feel like it's worth me sharing what I do and the steps that I'm taking to get to this point, you know? And like, I think that's today especially kind of what I realized, that I want to post on YouTube to help you guys, not for views or likes or to be famous or any of this. I just want to share what I've done for the last 11 years, and more specifically the last 4 years, to build the physique and build the mindset and the discipline and the work ethic that I have. I don't know, like, I just feel like there's something missing in the fitness industry right now. And I feel like a big part of that is someone paving the way to show what you can achieve naturally if you give absolutely everything you have to it, you know? Like, day in, day out. Because that's what it's been for me the last 3 years. And that's why it bothers me when people accuse me of being not natural. Like, I can honestly say that every year I could probably, like, count on my two hands, like, how many meals I eat that I don't weigh out. Like, I eat and I train and I live and I sleep and I do all these things to be the best physical version of myself. I do all these things as if I'm trying to be Mr. Olympia, but I'm not. That's not what I want to be. It's not what I've ever wanted to be. I've always wanted to be, if anything, the appealing physiques to me have always been like actors. Chris Evans, Chris Hemsworth. Sure, you can say that plenty of their roles, they probably were on PEDs, but you're an idiot, quite frankly, if you think some of those physiques can't be obtained naturally. Because some of the physiques, and I can honestly say this, some of the physiques that those actors had that I saw when I was like 12, I've already surpassed. Yeah, it took me 11 years, but like, I don't know. It's just upsetting to me that people are putting these standards of what can be obtained naturally, but no one has actually gone out and figured it out themselves. You know, like, you have all these 20-year-olds, 18-year-olds, heck, even like, even guys older than me, 28, 30, however old you may be, saying, oh, that's not naturally achievable. But it's like, dude, how the fuck do you know? Like, I know that there's only a certain amount of muscle you can put on naturally, but at the same time, the only true, definite way to know what you can achieve naturally is by giving everything you have to bodybuilding and staying natural and doing those daily habits for years on end until you're like 40. You know, like, no one does that. I feel like there's so little influencers who document that journey, that show what can be achieved naturally in a lifetime. And I feel like that's what I want to try and show. And I just want people to understand that you shouldn't be just sacrificing your health and longevity to be the biggest guy in the gym, when if you just learned to love the process and stayed natural, probably would achieve things, you would eventually achieve a physique that you didn't think you could achieve naturally. But everyone just wants to take the shortcuts nowadays. And I want to show that if you don't take the shortcuts and you actually just love the process and you put in the work, you can achieve things naturally that you didn't think you were capable of. So that's the plan. That's what I want to do. 2024, I want to try and inspire people and show people what it takes to build a great physique naturally, and to prove to people that you can build an incredible physique naturally. and you will be glad, so glad, 10 years from now if you stay natural and put in all that work naturally instead of taking whatever it may be to try and shortcut something, you know? And again, look, if you're taking PEDs for your health, like you're prescribed testosterone, or you are trying to be Mr. Olympia, then I understand. You have to do that. But 90% of people, if not more nowadays, neither of those things apply. They are just taking whatever it may be in probably an unsafe manner. They're wasting all their money. They're ruining their health. And I think a lot of people just assume like, oh, if I take steroids, I'll eventually achieve a physique where I'm so huge and so shredded that I'll love how I look, or I'll be the biggest guy in the gym. And it's like, yeah, maybe you will eventually be the biggest guy in the gym, but I can tell you firsthand, talking to people that are on steroids, the body dysmorphia does not go away. Body dysmorphia is something that you internally have to fix. No performance-enhancing drugs are going to fix your body dysmorphia. If anything, it will probably make it worse. That's my rant. And that's a push day, and I've been here for truly eons, so I'm going to go home, I'm going to eat some food, and I'll see you guys in the next one.